Hello students, I am Dr. Gajendra Purohit. I upload videos for Engineering Mathematics BSc on my YouTube channel. If you are preparing for any competitive exam, where higher mathematics is asked, my videos are very helpful for you. I have uploaded videos on all these topics like linear algebra, real, complex, modern, numerical and vector calculus, differential equations, partial differential equations and many more. The link will be in the description or you can watch through iTab. Today I am going to discuss linear differential equations of the first order, first degree. And how do we solve it? Let me tell you that linear equations are in both x and y terms. How can we determine whether this is linear in x or y? I want to inform you that these differential equation videos are an updated version. Previously, I had already uploaded videos, so you can still watch those older ones. The links will be available in the description box and the I button. This is version 2.0 of the series, right? Now, let's see the linear differential equations. How can we identify and how can we find out whether the differential equation we have is linear in x or y? Let's say if we have this differential equation given here. Please pay attention here if it is given. dy by dx. And here it is given as plus xy is equal to x cube. Let's say this differential equation is given here. Y is given only once and x is given twice. That means this differential equation will be linear in y, right? Now let's say if equation is given like dy by dx equals to, sorry, it is plus, right? So plus xy is equal to x cube y cube. This means y and x appears twice. This indicates that the expression is not linear in y. So we'll approach this differently. I'll explain how it can be reduced to a linear form in my upcoming class. Let me tell you that whenever we need to find out if it's linear in x or y, if y appears once and x appears twice, then it will be linear in y, right? P and q here, either they will be functions of x or constants, right? Whenever we have to solve this type of equation, we need to find its integrating factor, which is e to the power of the integral of p dx, right? And if its answer is linear in y, then it is y dot if. If it is linear in x, then it is x dot if. If it is linear in t, then t dot if. And integration of q dot if into dx plus c, this is its method. I will explain here with some examples. Let's see how we can solve this question. We have a differential equation here. What's the first thing we need to do? We will make the coefficient of dy by dx 1. We need to find out if it is linear in x or y. Since y appears once and the rest is a function of x, this equation is clearly linear in y. Divide x plus 1, we will get dy by dx. We will divide this. So minus y upon x plus 1 is equal to e to the power 3x. X plus 1 whole square will be divided by x plus 1. So we are left with only x plus 1. Here, value of p will be minus 1 upon x plus 1 and the value of q will be x plus 1 into e to the power of 3x. Clear? Now, first of all, we will find the integrating factor. It is e to the power of the integral of p dx, right? Now, students get confused and ask, sir, when does p dy come? Well, this is x. So the integration will be with respect to x, right? It will be e to the power minus 1 upon. 1 plus x integration of dx is equals to e to the power minus log 1 plus x. The minus sign will go to the power. It will be e to the power of log. I can write 1 plus x to the power of minus 1 because the power becomes negative. Log gets cancelled by e. So this becomes 1 plus the inverse of x. Or we can write this as 1 by 1 plus x, right? And this will be its integrating factor. Is it clear? We know that the answer we get here is y dot if. It is equal to the integration of if dot q dot dx plus c. This method is very important because it will be used a lot in further concepts. In the upcoming videos, when we will study higher order differential equations, this will be very useful. Now the integrating factor is 1 upon 1 plus x. The q we will get is e to the power 3x multiplied by 1 plus x dx plus c. Because we have q here, I have written it here. 1 plus x gets cancelled here. This will be y upon 1 plus x. And it is equals e to the power 3x and divided by 3 plus c here. Now multiply this term by 1 plus x here, then what we will get? Yes? So, when we multiply 1 plus x by this, we get this as the answer. This is how we can solve this type of differential equation easily. Let's see the next question and try to understand it as well. When students see this question, they get confused with the method. Look here, y is only given once, that means it is linear in y. And we have to solve this by making it linear in y, right? It is x cos x. We will divide it. And note that if it is also linear in y, then it will be dy by dx. Now dy by dx. And we will divide this x cos x, right? So when I will divide x cos x, this will be x sin x. Plus this will be cos x. This whole term divided by x cos x, which is equal to 1 divided by. It will become x cos x, right? And we know that the value of p will be this one. So p is equal to x sin x and plus here. Cos x, and I will divide both the terms by x cos x separately here. and the value of Q, what do I do here? Because cos will be inverse, so I will write this as sec x upon x here. This will be the value of Q, right? This cos will become sec on inversing. Is it clear, students? Now what we will get here? The x will be cancelled out with x and we'll get P is equals to tan x plus 1 by x. We will calculate the integrating factor of P. So this will be e to the power of the integration of P dx. This will be e raised to the power of the integration of tan x here and plus log x into dx. And what is the integration of tan x? The integration of tan x is log of sec x, clear? And here we will get log x and log a plus log b will be e to the power of log x sec x, right? And we will cancel the log with e. This will give us x sec x, which is the integrating factor here. Is it clear? We will get this integrating factor. Now we will solve it, since this is linear in y. So this will be y dot if is equals to if dot q dot dx plus c. Y will come as it is, and what is the value of if? It is x. Sec x is equal to, this will be if, x sec x. And what is the value of q here? The value of q is sec x upon x multiplied by, it will be dx plus c, right? If we cancel out x with x here, then we will have yx. Sec x is equal to square of sec x dx plus c, and its integration is tan x, right? This will be x sec x, and here this will be tan x plus c. Hence, in this way, we solve this question here. Is it clear? You can easily solve this type of equation using this method. Now, how to solve a differential equation that is given linear in x? How will you know whether the differential equation is linear in x? In that case, the p and q here will be functions of y. X will be given once, and equation will be in form of dx by dy. Its integrating factor is e to the power of the integral of p dy. There it is p dx, because p is function of x, and here p is integrating function of y. And here it is linear in x, so x dot if, q dot if dot dy plus c is its method. Now let's solve this. Now I'm going to discuss some questions with you to help you understand. Look here, students get confused if this is linear in x or y, and which method will be used. X is given only once. This means it's linear in x, so we need dx by dy. So how do we write this equation? It's x plus 2y cube. Now we need dx by dy. So we need to take the reciprocal and move it to the other side. This will be y dx by dy. And here, y dx by dy. It's important to understand what is the form here. We will get dx by dy. And it will be plus px is equal to q. The x term will come along with p. Students get confused which term will be moved to the other side. So you have to take x to the other side. Clear? This will be our 2y cube. Is it clear? Now divide this equation by y. When we divide it by y here, then we will get minus x by y is equal to 2y square, right? We know the value of p which we will get. It will be minus 1 upon y and the value of q will be 2y square. Now let's discuss about the integrating factor here. And we know what is its integrating factor. Its integrating factor is e raised to the power of the integration of p dy, right? So this will be p dy and minus sign will be taken out from this e to the power. So this will be 1 upon y dy. And here this will be e raised to the power of minus log y. The negative sign will move up. So log y inverse. Log will be cancelled out by e. And we will get y inverse. That means 1 upon y will be the integrating factor. We know that this is linear in x. We will get the answer as x dot if is equal to if dot q dot dy. Note that it will be dy because it is x. So it will be integrated with respect to y, right? So x 1 upon y is equal to if. And the if is equal to 1 upon y and the q here. It is 2y square. So we'll get 2y square dy plus c. Now you can notice here that y will cancel out with y. X by y and y cancels out with y. So this will be 2y, right? We will take out 2 and we get y dy plus c. This will be x by y. On integrating this, we get y square by 2 and the 2 gets cancelled plus c. If we cross multiply y and solve it, so we will get y cube plus cy as the answer. Students, this is how we solve this differential equation. Let's move on to the next question. It is very important for exam and students get confused that how do we solve this? X is given once and the function of y is given twice. This means that this equation is linear in x. And dy by dx is given here. We need to get dx by dy, right? Multiply this and take it here, reversing it, right? Or multiply this by dx by dy. When you will multiply this by dx by dy, this is what we'll get here. Pay attention, it will be dx by dy plus x, right? And minus e raised to the power of minus tan inverse y is equal to 0. Students, here we will get 1 plus y square dx by dy plus x is equal to e raised to the power minus of tan inverse y. Now divide this 1 plus y square, and when you will divide this term, it will be dx by dy plus x upon 1 plus y square is equal to e to the power of minus 10 inverse y upon 1 plus y square as the value. The value of p as 1 upon 1 plus y square, and q will be e raised to the power of minus 10 inverse y upon 1 plus y square. Now we will find its integrating factor. We know that the integrating factor is e raised to the power of the integral of p dy clear, because this is function of p dy and linear in x. We had linear in term of y before, so it was p dx. Now pay attention to this. We will get e to the power of the integration of. So the value of p is 1 plus y square dy, right? So the integral of this will be e to the power tan inverse y, right? Now, students, we know that this equation is given linear in x, so it becomes x dot if is equal to if dot. It will be q dot dy plus c here. And now this is x into e raised to the power of. This will give us tan inverse y is equal to the integration of, we have here, e to the power tan inverse y. This is the integrating factor. So this is the value of q here, right? The value of q is e raised to the power of minus tan inverse y upon 1 plus y square dy plus c. Now e to the power of x plus tan inverse y, e to the power of minus 10. So these two will cancel out. So what we have left here is x e raised to the power of tan inverse y. This is equal to the integral of 1 upon 1 plus y square dy plus c. This will be equal to x e to the power tan inverse y, and its integration will be tan inverse y plus c. We just saw that in this way. We can solve this question here. You can solve this differential equation very easily. This concept is about how to solve linear differential equations involving x and y. Now you are given a differential equation in this question, which is frequently asked in exams. You have to determine whether this differential equation is linear in x or y. And if it is linear in y or x, what is the answer? Please let me know in the comment box. And also, how much time did you take to solve it? And also, how are you finding my new content, which I am re-uploading with lots of upgradation, and it's revised. So please let me know in the comments. Do like this video, share it, and subscribe to my channel. You can find my playlist for differential equations here, and my latest playlist where I am uploading new videos of differential equations. You can watch them from here and my short trick videos that I am uploading on the new channel. They can be very helpful for your exam. If you want to watch it, you can watch it from there, and students, you can subscribe to my new channel from here. You can follow me on Instagram. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to share the answer of this question in the comment box. Thank you so much for watching.